The CDC is urging people to consider stopping vaping as it investigates a fifth death potentially linked to e-cigarettes. The number of cases of severe lung illness possibly caused by vaping has surged to more than 450 in 33 states. Many involve the use of other substances, including the primary ingredient of marijuana, that's THC. Our Dr. Tara Narula introduces us to parents who say vaping nearly took their daughter's life.
She feels lucky to be alive.
For sure.
Ruby and Tim Johnson say instead of dropping their daughter Piper off for her freshman year of college,
she had a fever, she had a rapid heart rate.
They were watching her fight for her life in the ICU.
Every doctor that she saw asked her, "Are you a smoker?" She said no, and then they said, "What about e-cigarettes?" And she said yes.
Piper was diagnosed with Colorado's first case of a rare vaping-related illness. The college freshman had been vaping for more than 2 years.
We're parents who are mad that these things are out there, and we're mad that they're easily accessible.
Juul is the top-selling e-cigarette company in the U.S. and is often blamed for the surge in youth vaping. We spoke with CEO Kevin Burns last month.
But you don't think Juul caused it?
Well, some people could have used our product, but there's never an intent on the company's part to target youth to grow our business. That's been the assertion.
Targeting a younger audience happened, and then when Juul was called on it, they went, "Oh, sorry, we didn't mean to do that."
Piper Johnson recovered and says she will never vape again.
It's not worth it, and it's not worth the risk, and it's not worth, you know, seeing your parents cry as you're in a hospital bed.
And Dr. Tara Narula is here. Doctor, good morning. What a frightening mess this is.
It is.
Thousands of these products out there. What should people know about when they need to seek medical attention? Because something like 10 million Americans are vaping in some form.
Right. So some of the early signs would be shortness of breath, chest pain, fatigue, nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, or abdominal pain. And certainly the shortness of breath, if it starts to get worse over several hours or really becomes more severe, you need to seek medical attention. Some people have reported these symptoms getting worse over days, some getting worse over weeks. And we know that, you know, now possibly 5 deaths. All adults, although many of these cases, again, are young people.
So one of the screaming questions is, where was the FDA? Where were the regulators?
That is a great question. And so it's a very complicated issue. But essentially, the FDA got jurisdiction to regulate electronic nicotine delivery devices back in 2016. Mm-hmm. But they set a timeline till 2022, and that was going to be the date when they would review. That timeline has gotten pushed up now to May of this year, May of 2020. So hopefully
even 2016 is late in the game. I mean, it's been around for a decade.
It is. Many people saying this is too little, too late.
All right. And still so many questions. Dr. Tara Narula, thanks.